Hello friends, today's video lecture we are going to discuss about the vertebral column of the mammal, right? So in last video lesson we discussed about the vertebral column of the birds. Okay, so in this video lecture, the vertebral column of the mammal is long, rigid and rod, situated in the mid dorsal line of the neck region, trunk region as well as tail region. Okay. So in case of mammals, the vertebral column is, it is long, rigid and a rod like structure, or a rod which is situated at the mid dorsal line of the neck region, trunk region as well as the tail region. Okay. So the vertebral column of the mammal is consist of 45 vertebrae. Okay. If you see the vertebral column of the mammals, it contains the 45 vertebrae in case of primate. Okay. It is divided into 5 regions. The whole vertebral column of the mammals can be divided into 5 regions. So first of all, those 5 regions are, so first one is the cervical vertebrae. Cervical means neck region, right? Thoracic vertebrae. And third one is the lumbar vertebrae. And fourth one is the sacral vertebrae. And fifth one is the caudal vertebrae. So these 5 are the regions of the vertebral column which mammals. Okay. So this cervical vertebrae consists of 7 vertebrae in this column, and this thoracic vertebrae contains 12 to 13 vertebrae in their column, and this lumbar vertebrae contains 6 to 7 vertebrae in their column, and sacral vertebrae, it contains 3 to 4 vertebrae in its column, and last one is the caudal vertebrae which contains 16 vertebrae in the column. Okay, so first one is the cervical vertebrae, right? So in case of cervical vertebrae, it is a thin centra. It has a centra which is very thin, and it also have the neural spikes, right? So cervical vertebrae are the group of or column of the vertebrae. In cervical vertebrae we have total 7 vertebrae. So those 7 vertebrae have the thin centra, short neural spines also present, and reduced cervical ribs fused with the centra. Okay, they have the cervical ribs, but the condition is they have reduced cervical ribs, and along with that they fused with the centra and transfer processes, right? So whatever the vertebrae present in the column of this cervical vertebra, they have the thin centra and short neural spines, right, and reduced cervical ribs fused with the centra as well as transfer processes. Okay, so in case of cervical vertebra, the first cervical vertebra is nothing but the atlas vertebra. So in this case, what happens? It supports the skull, right? We know, already know that atlas is the bone of the vertebra which always supports the skull bone. Okay, so it supports the skull. It more ring-like in form, right? As compared to the other vertebra, it is somewhat more ring-like in structure, in ring-like in shape as compared to the others. Okay, and the centrum is considerably reduced. So already here mentioned, okay, centrum or centra is reduced. The centrum is considerably reduced. The neural canal is wide and divided by transverse ligament. Right, so in this case the neural canal of the atlas is divided by transverse ligament into 2 parts, right? So first one is the upper part is larger, right? So this transverse ligament dividing the neural canal into 2 parts. So first part is the upper part which is larger, so that larger portion is nothing but the neural canal. Right? So this ligament forms the upper part, is the larger, that's why this is the neural canal. And this neural canal will contain the spinal cord. Canal means away, right? So neural canal always contains the spinal cord. The lower part is smaller. Upper part is larger and lower part is smaller, and it is called as the odontoid canal. Okay. So this is the structure of the atlas. This is the anterior view of the atlas, which contains transverse ligaments, which divides the neural canal into 2 parts, right? And this have the spinal canal, right? which spinal canal which contains the spinal cord which passes over here, right? And this is the neural arch, and this is the neural spine, and this is the odontoid canal, right? Okay. And next cervical vertebra is the axis vertebra, right? So next our second cervical vertebra is called the axis vertebra. So in case of axis vertebra, the centrum is well developed. Okay, as compared to the atlas vertebra, the axis vertebra's what centrum is well developed. I BS odontoid process, right? The neural spine is laterally compressed. In case of this axis vertebra, the neural spine is laterally compressed, right? And looks like prominent, okay, looks like prominent vertical ridge, right? So in this case, the neural spine is laterally compressed. Because of compression, it looks like prominent vertical ridge, okay? It looks like a ridge, okay? And second point is that transfer process are very small, okay? So in this case, axis vertebra has transfer processes which are very small. Their posterior ends represents the reduced cervical vertebra. Okay. So in case of axis vertebra, their posterior ends, the vertebrae posterior end will represent the reduced cervical vertebra. Okay. So in this case, they have the reduced. Their size will be reduced in this case. Okay. So this is about the cervical vertebra, and in that cervical vertebra we have 7 cervical vertebras, right? So first cervical vertebra is called as the atlas, and second cervical vertebra is called as the axis. The next one is the 7th cervical vertebra, which is the last cervical vertebra. Okay. So in case of 7th cervical vertebra, the neural spine is longer as compared to the other cervicals, right? So as compared to the other cervicals, the 7th cervical vertebra have a longer neural spine, okay? And the centrum bears at its posterior end, okay? The centrum in this case bears at the posterior end, okay? Posterior end, and a pair of half facets, okay? If you see the 7th vertebra, it have the centrum at the posterior end and a pair of half facets, where first pair of thoracic ribs partially articulate. Okay, so in case of 7th cervical vertebra, they have a centrum which have the facets for articulation of the first pair of the thoracic ribs. Okay, so thoracic ribs can partially articulate with the centra of the 7th vertebra. Okay. The transfer processes are not bifurcated. Okay. So in this case, the transfer processes are not bifurcated. And second region of the vertebral column is the thoracic vertebra. Okay. So this is the structure of the typical cervical vertebra. Right. So these are the, they have the a basic structure of the typical cervical vertebra, which have this neural spine which is sharp as compared to the other rest of the cervical vertebra. And this is the neural arch, and this is the neural canal where the nerve cord will be passes, and these are the pre-zygapophyses, and this is the post-zygapophyses, and these two regions are the transfer processes, right? Okay. And next region of the vertebral column is the thoracic vertebra. So in case of thoracic vertebra, they are modified for providing articulation to the ribs. Okay. So in this case, the thoracic vertebra, they show some modifications for the purpose of the articulation to the ribs. To help the articulation of the rib, they are modified. Okay. The anterior 9 thoracic vertebrae are relatively small. Okay. So first anterior 9 thoracic vertebrae, in the vertebral column of the thoracic region, the first or anterior 9 thoracic vertebrae are relatively small. They are small in size. Okay. They are called as the typical thoracic vertebra. So those 9 vertebra which are present anteriorly are called as the typical thoracic vertebra. Okay. So in case of typical thoracic vertebra, how they look like? So in case of typical thoracic vertebrae, okay, so this is the structure of the
thoracic vertebrae.
Okay. The transfer processes are short, right? So in this case, the transfer processes are short and horizontal. They are not bifurcated, right? They are short and horizontal. Each transfer processes has on its underside.
Okay.
Each transfer processes has on its underside an articular surface. Means the transfer process of this typical thoracic vertebrae have the process. Sorry, they have the on its underside they have a articular surface. The articular facet for articulation with tuberculum of the ring. So this articular surface have helps to the tubular facets, which articulation with the tuberculum of the ribs. So tuberculum of the ribs will articulate with the tubercular facet, means the facet means the where the articulation will be formed. Okay. And next point is that the neural spines are long. Okay. The neural spines are long as well as slender and backwardly directed. Okay. So neural spines are small as compared to the cervical vertebra, and they have this slender like appearance and they are backwardly directed. So this is the structure of the thoracic vertebra, right? So where the neural spine is here, and these are the transfer processes, right? This is the post zygapophysis and this is the pre zygapophysis. This is the neural arch and this is the central. Okay. And next one is the other thoracic vertebrae. So after the first anterior 9 vertebrae are called as the typical thoracic vertebrae, and rest of this thoracic vertebrae are the other thoracic vertebrae. So in case of other thoracic vertebrae, the posterior 3 or 4 thoracic vertebrae bear a capitular facets. Okay. So the posterior 3 to 4, okay, the posterior 3 to 4 vertebrae of the other thoracic vertebrae will bear a capitular facet on the anterior facets. Okay, they bear the capitular facets on anterior facets on their center. Okay, the centra of the thoracic vertebrae have the capitular facets on the anterior facet at which is present at the center. Means the centra bears the capitular facets on their anterior facets. Okay, the neural spines are short. Okay, in this case also, the neural spines are short. Additional processes are found. In case of other thoracic vertebra, an additional process will be found above the pre-zygapophysis. So the vertebrae of this thoracic vertebrae have the one additional process which is present above the pre-zygapophysis. So that additional process is called as the metamorphosis. Okay, so metamorphosis is the reason or the structure which is the additional process present above the pre-zygapophysis. The third reason of the vertebral column is the lumbar vertebrae. Okay, so in this case, the lumbar vertebrae are large and strong. Okay, as compared to the other rest of the vertebrae, so this lumbar vertebrae is they are large and strong for the purpose of bear the powerful abdominal muscles, right? So this lumbar vertebrae is mainly found at the abdominal region, right? So the abdominal region is characterized by presence of a powerful muscles, right? So this vertebrae will helps in the protection or helping the abdominal muscles, right? And the centrum of the first 2 or 3 vertebrae bears the mid ventral processes, right? So in case of that vertebra, this lumbar vertebra, first two to three vertebrae, they bear mid ventral processes. So those mid ventral processes are nothing but the hypophysis. Okay, and it projects downwards and forwards. Okay, so the hypophysis will project downwards as well as forwards, right? So this is the structure of the lumbar vertebrae. This is the region of the centrum. Okay, this is the side view of the lumbar vertebrae. And okay, and next point, the neural spines are large. The neural spines in this case they are large and extended forward the pre-zygapophyses are nearly vertical. Okay. So neural spines are large. They have the large neural spines and extended forwardly. They are large as well as extend forwardly. And the pre-zygapophyses are nearly vertical. So in this case, the lumbar vertebra, the pre-zygapophyses are nearly vertical in nature and they are concave in structure. Okay. And the post-zygapophyses are twisted. Pre-zygapophyses are nearly vertical and concave, but the post-zygapophyses are twisted, and so that their facets are directed outwards. Okay. So in this case, post-zygapophyses are, they are twisted in form, because of that their facets are directed forwards. Okay. So this is the structure and this is the post-zygapophyses where the facets are outwards in nature, and this is the pre-zygapophyses, right? And third point is that the centrum has mid-ventral longitudinal ridge. Okay, the centrum of the lumbar vertebra have the mid-ventral longitudinal ridge with a prominent cavity on either side. Okay, this is the centrum of the lumbar vertebra which have a longitudinal ridge. Along with longitudinal ridge, they have the prominent cavity on either side of the centrum. Okay. The transfer processes of last lumbar vertebrae are bifurcated. Okay. So the last lumbar vertebra. Okay. In lumbar vertebra, there is a column of the vertebrae, right? And the last vertebrae or last lumbar vertebrae are, the transfer processes of the last lumbar vertebrae are bifurcated nature. Okay. And fourth region of the vertebral column is the sacral vertebra. Okay. So in case of sacral vertebra, the sacral vertebra are fused to form a composite structure. This is the point. Okay. So in case of sacral vertebra, they are fused. Okay. They are attached to form a composite structure, to give a rigid support to a pelvic girdle. Because this sacral vertebra is mainly confined to the pelvic region. To support the pelvic region, at the pelvic region, they have the pelvic girdle, right? To support the pelvic girdle, this sacral vertebrae can unite, they can join or fuse together for a composite structure. That structure will help to support the pelvic girdle. Okay. And next point is that the dorsal surface is very broad. Okay. The dorsal surface is very broad. The centrum is wide laterally. The centrum is wide, guess in lateral side it is very wide. And the neural spines is vertical. Neural spines are so vertical. See, this is the structure of the sacrum, right? So this is the neural spine which is vertical, right? So this is the neural spine which is vertical. This is the neural canal and neural arch where the neural nerve cord will be passes out. Okay. So the dorsal surface is very broad and centrum is wide laterally and the neural spine is vertical. Metaphyses present above the pre-zygapophyses. Okay. So this is the pre-zygapophyses, right? So this is the pre-zygapophyses and above this the metapophyses is present. This is the metapophyses which is present above the pre-zygapophyses. Okay. And third point is that the transfer processes are greatly expanded. In this case, the transfer process of this sacral vertebra have greatly expanded there and represent the transfer process and represents sacral ribs. Okay. So the transfer process of this sacral vertebra, they are greatly extended for the purpose of two which represents the ends of the sacral ribs. Okay. The transfer processes of the first sacral vertebra are immovably joined. Okay. Because in sacral vertebra, they are in fused form. Okay. So that's why the transfer processes of first sacral vertebra. Okay. First sacral vertebra are immovably joined because they are fused. Joint to ilia of the pelvic girdle. Okay, so here the point is the first sacral vertebra which have the transfer process. So those transfer process is fused in a manner that they can't move, and they will help the joining to the ilia of the pelvic girdle. Okay, hence this vertebrae, this sacral vertebrae is called as the true sacral vertebrae. So first sacral vertebrae is called as the true sacral vertebrae because it gives a help to the ilia of the pelvic girdle. Right? The last region of the vertebral column is the caudal vertebra. Right? So caudal means tail region. Okay. So the vertebra which is present at the tail region is called as the caudal vertebra. In case of caudal vertebra, they gradually decrease in size. Means in case of caudal vertebra, the size of the caudal vertebra is decreased. Means small in size. Okay. And neural arch is short. So neural arch is short. This is the neural arch which is short. And neural spines are directed backwards. So these are the neural spines which directed backwards. First, the caudal vertebrate, it has very decreased in structure, right? And the neural arch is short and neural spines are directed backward. The transfer processes are very thin but broad. Okay, so in this case, the transfer processes are present and they are very thin but they are very broad in nature. Okay, and second point is that the metaphysis is present above the pre-zygapophysis, as like in earlier vertebra also, metaphysis is present above the pre-zygapophysis, and post-zygapophysis is present at another end of the vertebrae. Means both pre-zygapophysis and post-zygapophysis also present. So this is the pre-zygapophysis region, this is the post-zygapophysis region, right? So this is about the vertebral column of the mammals, right? I hope this video helpful for you. Thank you.